Your Royal Highnesses, Excellencies, dear all partners of change. Thank you so much for inviting me to address the value of youth participation in building democracy. It is of the highest importance that young people take part in democracy, because young people constitute a significant part of the population, and democracy is about inclusiveness. Young people have their own unique experiences and often also challenges which are important to take into consideration when political decisions are made. Many young people have a vision, hopes and expectations for a better today and tomorrow. And young people have energy, enthusiasm, and often a fighting spirit, which is essential to also channel into political processes. For me, as president of the Oslo Center, I believe in youth participation wherever you are in the world, no matter in which country you live your life. Yesterday, I came back from Pakistan after having followed closely the election as a leader of an international election observer delegation. What really encouraged me was to see how young women and men participated in the election with enthusiasm and dedication, despite all the threats and violence going on in the campaign and during the election day. Many young voters were mobilized under the slogan "Change," which was used by one of the main and successful political parties in Pakistan. In many countries, participation in democracy is dangerous. The road to democracy in fragile states is even more dangerous. To express your opinion, to take part in debates, to stand up for your political, economic, human rights often comes with a risk. People are suffering and imprisoned, and even pay the ultimate price only because they try to make the world a better place through democratic means. For young people to participate in building democracy, there must be spaces and opportunities to do so, by engaging in freedom of speech, identifying of democratic legislation, rules and procedures, building and strengthening democratic political institutions, the rule of law, and good governance. That is why we at the Oslo Center has made democracy assistance as our main program. We support political parties and civil society by providing technical and practical advice, drawing on experiences from our own and other countries. We highlight the importance of inclusivity and equality in political representation and participation, stress the importance of human dignity and consequently human rights, and pay a special attention to gender equality and the rights of the minorities, vulnerable and marginalized groups. In support of political cooperation and work with political actors, the Oslo Center creates meeting spaces and venues for dialogue. Mechanisms are created in order to share experiences on consensus-based politics and how to reach compromise, dialogue between individuals and institutions, including civil society and political leaders, to bring them together. Working with youth organizations and women organizations is given particular attention. Our purpose in establishing meeting places is to increase knowledge and build confidence, and to enable formulation of innovative political solutions. To be more concrete, together with local partners, we have now established a youth dialogue forum in the youngest state of the world, namely South Sudan, only 1.5 year old, almost two now. This forum includes participants from all the 10 states in the country. The majority of the interim board is women. They come to sort out their challenges towards a common future in a country mostly run by elderly men. We're also doing assessments on establishing a youth dialogue forum among minority and majority youth in the country mentioned by the moderator in Burma. Our main focus is the northernmost state, Kachin, in which fightings are continuing between the government forces and the Kachins. The Oslo Center conducted a youth forum in November last year, and we are continuing planning more forums among the Kachins and other minorities in the country. In Kenya, we cooperate with the Inter-Party Youth Forum, organizing a workshop for youth politicians from different political parties. The aim of the workshops is to raise awareness among the youth politicians on the importance of child rights, the rights of the children. Among the population of Kenya, over 60% are under the age of 35 years. The number tells us how crucial it is to listen to younger people and to include them in the governance, also in order to realize the rights of the children. When building democracy, the key words are trust and confidence. To build trust among younger generations is of main importance when it comes to build sustainable governance. When young people in their diversity come together and discuss issues of common interest and concern, when they build consensus and compromises whenever possible, they can make significant contributions to democratic development. But we should also recognize that many people, including young, do not have the highest level of confidence in political institutions and in politicians in many countries. Time is overdue to appreciate new avenues for democratic participation, for instance, electronic and social media. This is an opportunity for governments, for parliaments and political parties, for all democratic institutions to move into the 21st century. I do believe that this is also a precondition for sound, sustainable, and successful business. It is possible to change the world for the better, not lose that vision. My own international engagement started at an early stage. As leader of a political party's youth organization, I visited several countries and met young political leaders in Latin America back in the beginning of the 70s. I was impressed and inspired by their fight against the military regimes and for the democracy. And also in the beginning of the 70s, visiting African countries to see how young Norwegians in the Peace Corps contributed in the fight against poverty had also a strong impact on my own further political engagement and commitments. I was elected to the Norwegian Parliament when I was only 26 years old. I do believe it is of great value that parliamentarians represent different ages, sexes, sexualities, and ethnicities. I have always, as a parliamentarian and later on as Prime Minister, discussed with and listened to representatives of youth organizations and students. The perspectives from young people must not only be voiced, be heard, be listened to. The perspectives of young people must be included in the democratic processes and mechanisms. I believe in creating inclusive forums for dialogues in individual countries and internationally. It's my experience, it works. Dialogue among youth, building respect for one another, is a fundamental key for building sustainable democracies. Thank you.